We're here in Gaborone, Botswana for the annual Democracy Forum 2014, which welcomes a range of speakers and participants from government, academia, multilateral organizations, think tanks, NGOs and the private sector. 2 days of discussion, debate and knowledge sharing will focus on how to foster democracy and development through the sound management of natural resources. Botswana is this year's chair of the Council of Member States of International IDEA, the Institute for Democracy and Electoral Assistance, headquartered in Stockholm, Sweden, with whom it's co-organizing this year's forum. The forum aims to drill down into the detail on how countries can sustain the principle of democracy while pursuing their development objectives, bringing into focus the challenges of balancing and promoting the two priorities. International IDEA argues that the link between democracy and development becomes even more pressing in the case of resource-rich democracies. Natural resources have the potential to generate substantial sources of income and opportunities for economic growth. At the same time, however, there are challenges in terms of how to maintain and distribute this growth and ensure that it's done equitably and in an environmentally sustainable way. These issues will be front and center of discussions in the coming days, together with reflections on the ongoing post-2015 agenda discussions through the lens of democracy and development. Sessions aim to highlight the role of gender and the participation of marginalized groups in sound resource management, while identifying best practices in areas such as PPPs, cooperation between government and civil society, and CSR initiatives that advance democracy and development objectives. Another, perhaps unlikely, source of buzz here this week is the role of legal frameworks and international standards to ensure the good governance of natural resources. So far, we've heard from International IDEA's Secretary General Yves Leterme, former Belgian Prime Minister, about how the principles of democracy are promoted alongside development, with concrete examples from Tunisia, Botswana and Ghana. We've also spoken with Felix Mongai, CEO of the Kalahari Conservation Society, about win-win situations for natural resource management through effective partnerships with private sector actors. And we heard from Lamek Tekela, ambassador of Botswana to Sweden, about the key measures taken by Botswanan authorities to deliver equitable gains for society from the country's lucrative diamond industry. Stay tuned to devex.com in the coming weeks for a series of video interviews, guest commentaries, must-reads and exclusive insights on the themes of democracy, development and natural resources management.